I'm gonna jump in here because I was impressed. I have a different perspective and a different approach to interviews. There's something about all of us in our childhood that is a defining moment. And when I was researching about you, you used to preach at your sister's dolls, and you would go home from church services on Sundays, and you would get your mother's bathrobe and put it on like it was the bishop's robe. So it sounds like early in your life, you actually knew your passion.
Yeah, I was about 3 years old, and my parents had been members of the Church of God in Christ in Brooklyn, New York, where I was born. And they put me in what was called the junior usher board, which was just the kids would help the older ushers pass out programs and all as people came into the worship service. But I became totally enthralled with Bishop Washington, the bishop of the church. So I used to go home from church every Sunday and put on my mother's bathrobe and preach what I heard him preach to my sister's doll. A year later, they had the junior usher board anniversary. Once a year, they would do this to make all the kids feel good. And it was about maybe 15 or 20 of us. And the adult advisor, Hazel Griffin, said to me and all the kids, "What do y'all want to do on the program?" And my sister said she wanted to sing a solo, wanted to sing a song. Riley Dyson, who ironically later became a big Broadway star, he was about two, three years older than us. He wanted to read a poem. They got to me, I said, "I want to preach." And all the kids laughed. She said, don't laugh. Maybe that's his calling. She brought me to the bishop. And the bishop said, "Well, let me preach." I said, as a kid. And they let me preach at the junior usher board anniversary. I was 4 years old. They had to put me on a box because I was too small for them to see me. And I started preaching. And then every once in a while, they let me preach. By the time I was seven, I started doing the youth services at all the churches in Brooklyn. And they started calling me the Wonder Boy Preacher. That's how I got started. When I was nine, I actually preached on Mahalia Jackson's program. She came to New York. And that's how I got started. Was